My husband, Randy Johnson, was a good man. He made everyone he met feel important, that they all had a purpose. Randy, you are the love of my life.
You don't know how happy I was these last 10 years. To be in the arms of my true father. I love you.
I don't know if I can ever forgive you. You shouldn't have accepted him. He's not part of our family.
I think we should all go back to our homeland.
Our homeland? No. This is our home. This is where we'll stay.
This will always be our home. But I think we need to get away. We need to forget.
Dad had only passed away for a few months. And you want to forget him?
Brandon, I love your father. I will never forget him. Our marriage was everything I have ever hoped for.
Except for the day you allowed him to be seduced by that cheap woman in that town.
Hey, wait a second. My mother isn't some cheap tramp.
Hey, stop it. Stop it, both of you. Enough. I am now the head of this family. We are all going back to our homeland, and that is final. Brandon! Brandon, I'm still talking to
Mother,
you!
Mother, just let him go. I don't want to make things harder than they are. Especially for you. I know I lost my birth mother 10 years ago, and my father was just a stranger. But you took me in. And accepted me as one of your own.
Travis, you're exactly like your father. It was easy for me to love you. I don't care who gave birth to you. To me, you are my son.
Thank you, Mother. Well, Mother, I have a friend back in our homeland. I'll give her a call. Maybe she can help us find a house.
Who is that?
I've known her for a long, long time. She's my best friend. Pucknut.
Dear daughter Jasmine, you play the guitar so well. Did you notice how much the people applauded your performance earlier?
Mother, this is the last time for me, okay? You always volunteer me for that same fundraising event every year, and each time you make me play the same piece. You know I don't like to perform anymore, right?
Oh, my Jasmine. I don't go there and ask them to let you sing.
The organizers of the event keep requesting for you. Besides, it wouldn't be right to refuse them. After all, it is a charity fundraiser. Just think of all the people you'd be helping with that beautiful talent of yours. But Mother, I can help out in other ways aside from performing.
Will you hurry up? You're not finished packing yet. You're so slow.
Okay, I'll be done in a minute.
Hurry up or we'll leave you behind. Hurry up, will you?
Be honest with me. What's the real reason that you've lost your interest in playing the guitar? Because I remember, when you were 6 years old, you dragged around that guitar of yours everywhere you went.
Our ship is scheduled to leave at 8 p.m. You don't have to wait for me.
Take care of yourself. A lot of people will take advantage of you in the big city.
I'll be all right. You take care now.
Bye.
Bye. You have a safe trip.
Clean that up. Make sure everything's secure. Hey, you two, what took you so long? Tie up everything safe and secure. We're leaving any moment now.
Hurry, hurry.
Okay. Here we go.
Bring the captain. Let's go.
All right.
Secure the crane. All right, get down from there.
Be careful.
Get ready with the ropes. All right, easy, easy. Bring it over here. There you go. Hey, watch it, watch it.
Hey, mate! The captain wants you.
Spot.
Scared me. I thought you were dead.
Well, I'm very much alive. Who are you anyway? And what are you doing here?
I sneak into the ship. I've been looking for a place to hide.
You can't hide here. This is my spot. Why don't you go and find your own place to hide?
Why can't you share? We're both hiding out anyway. There's room enough for both of us.
I was here first. I'm sure they're going to catch you. I don't want to be caught. Get out!
Please let me stay here with you. I'm tired of running and hiding so that nobody sees me. Can we get along with each other?
You can't stay. Get out! Get out! Get out!
Leave!
Go away! Leave!
I'm begging you, please, let me stay here.
You can't stay here. Where are you going? And will you wipe that smirk off your face?
I guess I don't have to leave after all. Please don't get mad. I'm sorry for everything. I didn't know that you were here. We can't do anything about it now. We're in this together. So please, don't be mad at me anymore.
Stop staring at me?
How can I not stare at you? It's so tight in here that we can barely move.
Well, close your eyes then. Go on.
But
I was here first, so you ought to follow me. Close your eyes. Here's your bag. From now on, this is your side and that is mine. Let's not have anything to do with each other. What is it now? You are supposed to stay on that side. Why are you on my side?
Here, wear my jacket. It's cold in here. I don't want you to be mad at me anymore.
All right, thank you.
You can call me Bok Bok. What's your name?
What is it you're looking at, huh?
So you don't want to tell me your name, huh? I'll just make one up for you. Bok Nat, because you've got a huge bald spot in your head.
You have no manners!
Ouch! Ouch! There, I finally made you laugh. Why do you want to go to the city? Are you running away?
I'd like to try my luck in the big city. I hear people say that there's money to be made. The city is where my fortune lies.
Money? But you're too young to look for a job.
I often catch my mother crying. She is having a hard time working. We barely even have enough money for food. I'd like to help her, so I decided to look for work in the city.
What kind of work?
I play the guitar really well. I'll be playing in all the street corners. I'm sure people will pay for my songs. What about you? What are you going to do there? Will you be looking for a job too?
I'm looking for something else. My father. He is an American. My neighbor told me that. The company that he works for has its country office in the city. I hope to find him there. I wish it were true. It's a bit scary for me.
This is scary for me too. I don't know what's going to happen when we get to the city. But I'm doing this for my mother. Do you know where your mother is?
She died. That's why I need to look for my father. I don't have anywhere else to go.
Please stop crying. You know what? Why don't we help each other when we get to the city? We're both alone anyway.
You're a real friend.
Bok Bok, wake up! It's morning! Bok Bok, what's wrong with you?
It's so cold. I can't breathe.
It's all your fault. Why did you lend me your jacket when you needed it more than I did? I can take the cold better than you can.
It was the only way I could think of to make you laugh. I wanted to make friends with you.
All right. I'm your friend already. I know. I'll play the guitar for you. I'm sure this is going to make you feel better.
Magmanggat sa imong gugma kay unsa pay bili ning kinabuhi kung sa gugma mo hinikawa.
Captain's calling for us.
Get in!
No, you go first. Hurry.
You both cannot fit in there. Hurry, get in.
We have a stowaway.
Please have mercy, I just want to go to the city.
You little brat! How were you able to sneak in? I got you now. Come with me.
Have pity on me.
Come on.
Please don't hurt me. Have mercy, I just want to go to
the
city.
There.
Please have mercy, don't hurt me. Please, I just want to go to the city. Please have mercy, let me go.
Hey, what have you got there? Stowaway, sir. Hey, kid. We don't allow stowaways, especially little kids like you, huh? We can get into a lot of trouble if anyone finds you on board. What are you doing here?
Please have mercy, I just want to go to the city.
Oh, the city. Do you have any money?
No, sir.
Don't lie to me. You sure you don't have any money, huh? Okay, Roger, I'll take it from here. You have to pay your own way. For starters, I'm taking your jacket. Huh? Give me... Tough guy, huh?
No, please, have mercy, please! Have mercy!
Come on, get out of here!
No! Please, I have no money, I promise!
Listen to me. You know what I do to stubborn kids? I throw them overboard,
no,
to the
please,
sharks!
No, please! please,
Rusty,
no!
Huh?
Stop it!
Bok-Nat, why did you come out?
I'll save you, Bok-Bok!
Oh, another stowaway! Come on, get that girl!
No!
We got lucky in this trip. Lots of fish.
It's a good thing the seas were calm today.
Yeah.
Look, over there. What's that?
Come on, let's find out.
Let's go.
Are they alive?
Yes, they are. Let's bring them to the hospital.
Come on. Let's go.
This isn't the first case we've had that stowaways were thrown without mercy to the sea. Don't worry, child. We'll get those men and put them behind bars. Okay? Oh, I'm glad you're here. Let me see them. These are the reports on the incident.
Bok-Nat, is that really you? Did we survive?
Yes, we survived, Bok-Bok. Some fishermen found us washed on the shore. They brought us to this hospital.
Who are they?
They're from the mayor's office. They'll be returning me back home to my mother. Then the mayor will bring you to the U.S. Embassy in the city. He said that he will help you find your father.
Won't you be going to the city with me?
Not anymore.
You don't have to worry. I've arranged for everything. Young lady, you'll be going back home. Your mother is worried sick about you. As for you, young man, you're coming with me. The U.S. Embassy knows about your case. They will assist you in looking for your father. I'll be back.
Thank you for everything that you've done for me. Although we haven't really spent that much time together, you've become my best friend.
It's the same for me. You've become my best friend too. Here's my address. Be sure to write me, huh?
I write every day. Promise.
I'll miss you very much, Bokbo.
My mother was the one who gave me this when she was still alive. It's been with me ever since. I don't have anything else to give you to remember me by, so please accept this.
You'll be far away from me. We might not be able to see each other again.
Please don't cry. Whenever you start missing me, just hug that slipper and imagine that I'm holding the other one while I'm thinking of you.
Thank you for giving me your slipper.
We need to go.
Cross my heart. I'll come back for you, Boknat.
I'll wait for you, Bok.
See you again, Boknat. I miss you so much.
Emily, here are your letters.
Edgar!
Why?
You have a letter for me?
There's one for Emily. There's one for Boknat, Jasmine.
Thank you, Mr. Mailman.
Dear Boknat, I finally found my father. He's so kind to me. Father has a new wife. A new mother for me. She is also nice to me. I also have a new brother, Brandon. I don't think he likes me so much. He's always mad at me. How about you? How are you and your mother doing?
Dear Bokbok, Mother and I are fine. Don't worry about your brother, Brandon. If you could make me smile on the ship, I know you can make him smile. We're leaving our small town because Mother wants to work in the city. I hope we have better luck over there. I hate to see Mother crying all the time. I will write to you as soon as we get there, so you can write me back at our new address. From your best friend, Boknat.
Are you
George's cousin?
Oh, yes.
Come in. They've been waiting for you since yesterday.
What took you so long?
Let's go. Please come in. I'll show you where you'll stay. Come with me. It's this way. It's a small house at the back. It may need a few repairs, but it's clean and tidy. I'm sure
Don't forget
like
to
it.
Give me your new
I'm
address
so,
so that
here.
We can keep on writing each other. I miss you so much. But you know what? Every time I see a rainbow, I'm reminded of you. Then I'm not so lonely anymore. Because I imagine that you're at the other end.
Have you received our new address in the city? I've written you several times, yet you have yet to answer them. I miss our chats, best friend, and hope that you will write to me soon.
You promised that you'd write to me every day. It was easy enough for you to forget that promise. I thought we were the best of friends. I was wrong. If it's that easy for you to forget me, I don't want you either. I shall erase you from my life, Bok Bok. Boknat and Bok Bok are no more.
Jasmine, have you been crying? Han. I think you left this outside.
I'm sorry. You shouldn't have picked it up.
Why are you crying? Is there anything that happened? Han?
Emily? I'm hungry. Can you make me some pancakes?
Just give me a few minutes. Let me just finish my taco.
Oh, but I'm starving. Will you please make me some pancakes? Pretty please? I really like the way you make pancakes.
All right. You're such a persistent child. I'll make you some pancakes. While you're waiting, why don't you and Jasmine play for a while, okay? I won't be long.
Jasmine, let's go to your room. I'll bring out my tea set and we can play house. It will be fun. I promise.
All right, I'll just put this aside.
I'll also bring my doll so we can have a tea party. Just come by my room when you're ready. Jasmine, you want some tea? Jasmine?
Oh. I'm sorry. Yes, I would. Your tea is delicious, Camille.
Why do you look so sad?
It's because my friend has forgotten all about me. We made a promise to each other. We promised to write each other often. But he hasn't answered any of my letters for the past few months.
Never mind that. I'm here for you anyway. We're friends forever.
Thank you very much. But I think you're right, Camille. If Bok Bok doesn't like me anymore, then forget him. I don't like him either.
Bok Bok? What an ugly name. He's probably just as ugly.
Not really. You know what? He's actually nice. When we met, we almost died together.
Really? What happened?
We were stowaways on a ship. It was a fishing ship, and it was very large. And the freezer compartment was very cold. And then we were caught by a mean man.
Jasmine, what are you reading that's got you so interested in it for quite some time?
It's a list of those who pass the bar exams. I was imagining when my name would be on it.
Hun, that day will come for you. You don't have to imagine it to be true. I shall read your name on that bar exam list someday soon.
Emily, Jasmine, here's your newspaper.
Wow, you're a hard-working boy. Perhaps you can get it this time. Let's pretend that I'm your teacher. What's your name?
Sam.
There you go again, Sam.
Sam.
If you say so, then that's what I'll call you. Tam it is. Hey, Tam, how's your grandmother doing?
She's okay. I was about to go home, but I smelled something yummy. What did you cook today?
Why don't you eat with us today, Tam?
Yes, I would.
I was beginning to wonder why we were always last on your paper route. You planned this all along, didn't you? But you know what? You've come here at the right time. I've cooked your favorite dish.
Yay!
Oh, sit down.
Good morning, sir.
Tam, here's the beef jerky.
The buyer hasn't seen what we're selling, but I was able to close the deal on the phone. Yes, and I even got a big commission on it.
Beef jerky, Sam's favorite.
Beef jerky?
Mother? Mother!
Okay. I'll call you later, okay? Bye-bye. Yes, Camille?
Mother, didn't you inform them that we have visitors from America? Why are we serving beef jerky?
Listen, Emily. Why is that the only thing you cooked? You know very well I have guests coming in from America. They might think I'm a cheap host. Go back to the market and buy more food. I want to see dishes fit for a king on my table. And why aren't you wearing the uniforms I bought you, huh? Wear them for the guests. So you can at least look half decent.
Oh, Mother.
Jasmine, when the guests arrive, I want you to stay in the kitchen. Make sure everything is in order. And I don't want to see you wandering around, okay?
Yes, madam.
Clara, Camille, let's go. We'll be late going to the airport.
Don't forget my request, Emily.
Yes, madam.
I'm counting on you.
Hurry, guys. Let's not be late. Clara might be waiting for us by now.
Well, it's not my fault. Travis is so slow.
Slow? Well, half of your stuff is in my cart. I just wish you'd help me out.
Hey, guys, stop it. I think that's Clara. Clara! Clara!
Oh.
Thank you.
Bok Bok?
Boknut?
Mm-hmm.
At last. After all these years, we meet again. Is that really you?
Of course, just look at it. The picture, my face. Don't you think I'm the same girl, hmm?
Right. You are the girl in the picture.
Mm-hmm.
I just can't believe that you're right here in front of me. Boknut?
Hey, you! If it's okay, please don't call me Boknut. It sounds hideous, and it doesn't fit my image now. And Bok Bok sure doesn't suit you either. So, from now on, let's forget those names, okay?
Okay. Sure, we'll stop using those names. But, I will never forget that name. Boknut is a special name for me. It will always be in my heart.
At last, I've met the person I've been talking to all this time on the phone. Were you able to...
Oh, yes, Monica. You don't have to worry about anything. I arranged everything, including Travis's schooling. And even your house is ready, too.
Oh, good. Thank you. This is my son, Brandon.
Oh, you're Brandon. Hi. This is my husband, George.
Can we please talk about this somewhere else? It's hot, and I'm hungry. Where are we eating?
Brandon! Please excuse my son. He's a bit tired from our trip.
Oh, no, it's okay.
And this is my other son, Travis.
Oh, hi, Travis!
Oh, nice to meet you.
And this is my husband, George.
I'm Travis.
Hi.
I'm sure you like the house. I have impeccable taste when it comes to design. You can ask my husband, George. I'm very good at real estate. In fact, we've invested a lot in real estate. Right, George?
Are you in real estate, too?
No. Internal revenue.
That's not the only thing he does. Actually, George manages our rental properties. He has the time to do these things, as his job is not really that demanding. He just sits behind a desk.
Now, the fruit salad is done. You can dish it out to the guests.
But... I think that Camille prefers me to stay in the kitchen.
Oh, please, Jasmine. Look at all this. We still have a lot to do here. I can't do it alone. You've got to help me. As for Camille, don't mind her. Now, come on. Bring out the fruit before Madame Clara throws a fit. Hurry up, let's go then. I still have a lot to do.
Where can I get some water?
In the kitchen. I'll get it for you.
Oh, let me do it. I can help myself, thank you.
Travis?
Hmm?
Are you going to take off that stain?
Yes. I can hardly see it. But I don't want to risk it. It's my favorite shirt.
Jasmine!
I'm sorry, sir. I'm
oh, no,
really,
it's okay.
Really
don't bother.
Very sorry.
It's all right.
I'm
really.
So sorry, sir.